Welcome to this introduction to the research process. In this video, we will explore the basics of what it takes to complete a research assignment, such as a paper, presentation, or other research project. To start, let's talk about how research assignments are different from other kinds of assignments. Instead of using your personal views or opinions, completing a research assignment involves representing the ideas of others, citing how the author of each article, book, or other source explained their findings and how they argued their points. Showing evidence that proves your point is what makes your assignment scholarly as opposed to an opinion or reflection piece. A common misconception is that research assignments simply require that you find a handful of scholarly articles and dive right into the writing process. This is simply not the case. While some aspects of the research process may differ based upon the topic, discipline, or scope of the project, the steps will typically include identifying an initial topic, gathering sources, refining the topic, organizing information and citations, writing a draft, doing additional research to fill in gaps identified while writing the draft, and rewriting. This might seem daunting at first, but if we take our time and address each of these steps one by one, we will not only complete our research assignment, but do it without getting overwhelmed. Think of research as an adaptable, ongoing process and approach it with flexibility. Starting the research process is often the most intimidating part. While the professor usually provides a prompt when they give the assignment, much of the time it is up to you to come up with a relevant topic, find the information you need, and then bring together that information into a final product. When possible, try to pick a topic that satisfies the requirements laid out by your professor and that interests you. Even if you don't feel excited about the assignment itself, choosing a topic you're curious about can really help smooth out some of the wrinkles you may encounter later on. When choosing a topic, it can also be helpful to create a mind map. Mind mapping is simply a brainstorming tool that helps us get beyond the blank page without worrying about structure or detail. This will help us make connections between concepts and see ideas in different ways. For more information on mind mapping, check out our related videos, Introduction to Mind Mapping and Creating a Digital Mind Map. Whether or not you mind map, this brainstorming step is critical. It's important to identify the questions, confusions, motivations, and methods you're carrying into the research process. Ask yourself, what interests me about this topic? What's the time limit on this assignment? Why am I being asked to write this research paper? What questions do I have, and what am I nervous about? Often, the nervousness we feel when starting an assignment is simply a result of not knowing. We can only address a problem and fill in gaps in our understanding once we know what they are and where they came from. Answering a few of your initial questions right away is an easy way to boost your confidence. This includes looking up words and concepts with which you might not be familiar. Google is not the best place to find scholarly articles, but it can be a useful way to broaden your understanding and boost your confidence by clearing up smaller details. Also, be sure to confront your assignment honestly. Look at the syllabus, read the prompt again, look at your planner or calendar, and figure out exactly how long you have to do this assignment. Having a game plan will help ensure your success. Once your topic is finalized, it's time to collect some initial background information and choose which sources will be best suited for the topic. In most cases, the professor will require peer-reviewed sources. A peer-reviewed source is one that has been reviewed by scholars in the same field to make sure the information provided is accurate and worth sharing. As previously mentioned, it's important to note that, in general, Google is not a good place to look for peer-reviewed academic sources for your research project. One great place to find scholarly sources is the USM Library's website. Once you've found a few sources you think will help support your assignment, the next step is to refine your topic. Refining your topic simply means using the sources you've found to make the subject of your research more specific. It is important to note that USM students have access to a team of highly trained librarians who can help you with your research as well. Sometimes, something as simple as the words we use when we start searching for information can make finding sources more difficult. librarians can help us identify keywords to enter into databases and catalogs to more effectively and efficiently find sources. This saves time and allows us to focus more on crafting our final product. Revising the initial topic can also make it more researchable, reducing potential frustration when you're trying to find sources to cite. You can get in touch with a USM librarian in person at the Portland, Gorham, and Lewis and Auburn campus libraries, or by using the Ask a Librarian chat feature on the library website. Once the scope of the research topic has been narrowed, it's time to go deeper into the library website. Searching in one search allows us to see all of the books and articles the library can provide all in one place. Additionally, the A to Z list of databases provides USM students with access to thousands of online journals and other publications that are not available via a Google search. Subject guides, theme-based resources curated by USM librarians, are also found on the library's website. Okay, you've decided on a topic, found a few academic articles, books, or other resources to cite when discussing the subject of your assignment, and you've got just about everything you need to start writing. There is one more step we need to take before we begin, though, and that step is organizing our information and citations. Consider creating a Word or Google document for your citation sources, and save it with a name that is clear to you. Reference materials or references for X assignment are two good options. Make sure this document is easy for you to reach in case you need to jot down some notes or make changes on the fly. Taking this step now will also save you the trouble of properly formatting your citations once the assignment is written. We can get even more use out of this step by making what's called an annotated bibliography. Annotating a bibliography simply means that we add notes and make comments about each source we cite, such as a brief summary and an evaluation of its relevance to the research topic. Quoting key words and phrases from the author also makes the integration of sources easier when you sit down to write. Using this strategy will not only save time when you begin writing, also prepare you for future projects in which an annotated bibliography might be required. USM's online library also has a Cite My Source tool that will automatically format your citation in the style you need. There are a few different citation styles to choose from, so make sure you know which one your professor prefers. For more information on citation formatting, visit the Purdue Online Writing Lab at owl.purdue.edu. Use your notes and the thoughts you have about your topic to create a first draft. You can build upon it as you progress through the assignment, so don't worry about getting it perfect the first time. Use words and language that make sense to you. Don't worry about whether you sound academic or not. Review the prompt for the assignment and do your best to follow the guidelines given by your instructor. Never hesitate to email your professor if you have a question or need assistance. Additionally, know that writing is an ongoing process and everyone can become a better writer. Our team of USM writing assistants are here to help you do just that. Writing assistants are students just like you, who have been specially trained to help with all aspects of the writing process, including creating an outline, writing a draft, identifying issues with grammar and sentence structure, help with citation formatting, and much more. You can make an appointment with a writing assistant by using the Writing Assistance Scheduling link found in the My USM portal under the USM Quick Links tab, as well as on the right-hand side of the USM Brightspace landing page. While writing your first draft, you'll begin to notice gaps in your research or places where more information is needed. Keep a running list of things like this that you notice and use it as a guide when you jump back into the research process. USM librarians can also help us out at this stage. Rewriting and revision are important parts of the writing process. Taking a break from the assignment to let things simmer will allow you to form new ideas and think about your assignment in different ways. This will also give you time to seek feedback on your work from a classmate or writing assistant, which can be a powerful tool for your revising process. By this point, you will be much more familiar with your topic than when you started, and because you've kept your citations organized, it is simply a matter of piecing together your assignment in a logical way. This also reminds us of the importance of time management. Allowing enough time for careful and well-thought-out revision, on your own or with a writing assistant, will help ensure that you're turning in your best work. So to recap, spend time reviewing the parameters of your research assignment and brainstorming your topic. Use resources like OneSearch, USM librarians, and writing assistants to perform your research, narrow your topic, and start your writing. Make good use of the time you have and never hesitate to email or talk to your instructor if you need clarification. And remember, try to remain flexible when you approach your research. The goal is to teach you how to go about finding answers that are worth sharing with others, and the skills you develop while working on a research assignment will also help prepare you for the work you will do after college, regardless of what field you go into. Thank you for watching this video, an introduction to the research process. For more information on academic support strategies and resources, visit us at usm.maine.edu/agile.